Okay, so I'm going to call this chi-squared test for variance and standard deviation. Okay, and again, anytime I introduce a new test, I have to tell you what distribution, and I did that in the title, uses the chi-squared distribution. Okay, and this is another family of curves distribution. So I need to give you the degrees of freedom. So it's a chi-squared distribution. And your degrees of freedom is n minus 1. And again, if that's not located, then you do the closest lesser value. And then I need to introduce what the test value formula looks like. And it's kind of nice. It's one of the easier test formulas. So that's kind of good news for us. It's simply chi-squared equals n minus 1, in parentheses, times s squared, divided by sigma squared. And I'm going to put the O there with the sigma naught, because that's trying to indicate to you that that's coming from the hypothesized values. Okay? And that's it. It's a really easy test value formula, actually. So one thing that could be a little tricky, potentially, on some of these problems is, in the example, they could give you either the sample standard deviation or they could give you the sample variance. So don't be tricked on when you have to square this and when you don't have to square it, okay? If they say, hey, the sample variance is 20, then that's telling you s squared is equal to 20. You don't have to square it. But if it says the standard deviation is 8, then you're plugging in s is 8, and then you have to square 8, okay? So that's one of the little tricks that happens a lot. Okay, let's get some practice just setting up the critical values. So let's do example one here. Find the chi-squared critical value for 15 degrees of freedom, alpha's 0.05, and left tail test. All right, here we go, example one. We have the degrees of freedom is 15. We have alpha's 0.05. We have left tail test. And I just want you to tell me what the critical value is. Okay. So to be able to do that, I need to be able to look it up in my chart. So get out your chi distribution chart. And we have to remind ourselves how this works, right? The chi-squared one's a little bit tricky because it gives you area to the right, as opposed to the other tables give area to the left. So let me draw what I'm trying to do here. I have a left tail test. So some area in the left tail, here's my critical value, and this area is equal to 0.05. And my degrees of freedom for this problem is 15. Okay? So what I need to do is open up my chi-squared distribution, and in the book, it gives area to the right. It doesn't give area to the left. Okay? So if I'm trying to identify this value with 0.05 area to the left, that means it's 0.95 area to the right, okay? So just keep that in mind. When we're looking in the book, it's area to the right. So I'm gonna go to the very top, I'm gonna go to 0.95, because I'm looking area to the right. And then I'm gonna go down to 15 degrees of freedom. So 0.95, 15 degrees of freedom. And hopefully everybody sees that that gives you the value 7.261. So that means 7.261 is the critical value for this problem, for this setup. Okay? So again, this chart gives area to the right. So if I want to do a left tail test and it's 0.05 to the left, that means the area to the right is 0.95. So in my chart, I look up 0.95. Okay? Questions on that? It's super important that you can set up the critical value because that tells us if we're going to reject or not based on where our test value lies. Okay? Let's try another one. Let's do example two here. Let's say alpha is 0.10. Let's say the degrees of freedom is 28. And let's say it's a two-tail test. All right, so spend a minute. Draw your picture, and I want you to tell me what both critical values are, the left critical value and the right critical value. See if you can get that. While you're working on it at your seat, I will try to draw it. And then we can check each other's answers. So if I was doing this problem, I would go down to 28 degrees of freedom, and because alpha is 0.10, we have, and it's two-tailed, we have half the area in both tails. This one's going to be the easiest to look up. Just go to 0.05 and go down to 28 degrees of freedom. And if I do that, you get 41.337. Does everybody see that? So that'll be my right critical value, 41.337. That one's pretty easy because my book is set up to give area to the right. To get this left critical value, I need area to the right of this, which would be 0.95. So you go to 0.95, and then go again down to 28 degrees of freedom. And it looks like it's 16.928. So my left value will be 16.928. Okay, any questions on that? Did everybody get those two values? Again, that's crucial because then we're going to do the test value and then we'll see if we reject or not, okay? All right, let's do an example or two. Okay. 18 containers of fruit punch are selected and each is tested to determine its weight in ounces. The variance of the sample is 6.5. Test the claim that the population variance is greater than 6.2 at alpha equals 0.01. Okay, so we're looking at 18 fruit containers. So I'm just going to write down the basic information. N was 18. We looked at 18 fruit containers. And we're studying the variance. It says the variance of the sample was 6.5, so a variance of sample. It says test the claim that the population variance is greater than 6.2, so test claim, population variance is greater than 6.2. And it says to use alpha at 0.01. Okay. So, again, we're going to go through a traditional hypothesis test here. And step one will be HOH1. And today we're doing a test not for mean, which is mu, not for proportion, which is P, but for variance or standard deviation, okay? And in this, it's saying test the claim that the population variance is greater than 6.2. So population variance, first of all, what is our symbol for population variance? It's this guy, right, sigma squared. And we're saying greater than 6.2, so that obviously has to be in my alternative hypothesis because there's no equal sign with it, right? And we've memorized there's always an equal sign with the null. So this is my claim. Okay, and that starts kind of our dominoes, right? So based on this, it tells me what type of test it is, right? Then I do my critical value, then I do my test value, then I reject or not based on that, okay? Okay, so good. If this is my null, alternative, then my null is the opposite. And I'm ready to go to step two. Based on this setup, this is a right-tailed test. So we need to draw a right-tailed picture and get my critical value. And they give you an alpha of 0.01, so this shaded area is 0.01. Okay? Well, good news is our book is ready to go with right-tailed area, because that's how our book is set up for chi-square. So this one should be really easy. I'm going to go look up 0.01 in my book, and I'm going to go down to 17, because the degrees of freedom on this problem is 17. So 17 and 0.01, and hopefully you guys see 33.409. That's gonna be my right tail critical value, 33.409, and I'm literally reading that off my charts. Okay, so I've got step one down, I've got step two. Now again, something that's really nice and easy today is the test value formula is really easy. Okay, so write down the test value formula. We're on step three now. Chi squared equals n minus 1, so 17. And then we have to be careful, okay? In my formula, it's s squared. It says in the problem, the variance of the sample is 6.5. Well, that is s squared, right? So I don't have to square that. So just put 6.5. And then in the bottom, it says the hypothesized sigma squared, which was sitting over here. Our hypothesized sigma squared is 6.2. So this test value formula is pretty easy, right? Just 17 times 6.5 divided by 6.2. Okay, so that one shouldn't be too bad in your calculator. And I'm getting about 17.8226, approximately 17.8226. Okay, I bring my test value over to this picture. It would need to be to the right of 33 to be in there, right? And 17, I don't know, maybe here somewhere. And I'm gonna label that as my test value. Since my test value is clearly not in my rejection region, then step four, we do not reject HO. Okay, remember step four is always either reject HO or do not reject HO. So in this case, we're not rejecting HO. So if I'm not rejecting HO, I'm gonna circle it, and I'm gonna cross the line through the other. The claim was that the population variance is bigger than 6.2. We don't have enough evidence to support that, okay? So in my own words, step five, we don't have enough evidence to support the claim that it's greater than 6.2, okay? So put that in your own words. Not enough evidence to support claim. And that's it. Okay, any questions on that? It's just building on what we've already done before, right? It's a new test. I just need to tell you what the distribution is. It's chi-squared, okay, so you have to be really careful with the critical value. And then I have to give you the test value formula. It's really easy. N minus 1 times s squared over sigma squared. And you guys can handle a right tail test, a left tail test, or a two tail test, just like we've always done it. Okay? Questions on this one? Okay.